Hello students, welcome to this new lecture series of development of lateral surfaces of solids. This is the first lecture in this particular series and in all my seventh lecture in this engineering graphics for all of you. Okay, so welcome to this one again in this particular lecture series. What do you mean by development of lateral surfaces of solids? Now, before moving to this particular topic, already in the classroom sessions, I have shared you about this various kinds of solids. Now, these are the solids which are generally taken into consideration for drawing their lateral development. Now, these all solids are known as right circular solids. There is another type of solid which is known as oblique solid, but that is not in our syllabus, so we will not going to consider that. Now, what do you mean by right circular? Its axis is perpendicular to its base. Okay, these are somewhat in this fashion. Therefore, if we put it in vertical manner, then its axis is perpendicular to its base. So in this sphere we are not going to consider, but for the others we can draw this lateral development of surfaces. Especially we will go for cylinder, then prism with the help of parallel line development method, as well as cone and this pyramids with the help of radial line development method. Okay, so one should know what do you mean by a solid and what are the types of solids. Already in the classroom sessions, okay, I have told you, we have drawn its elevation, that is front view and top view, that is orthographic projection of for some of the solids. Now, these solid objects are generally, in this case of development of lateral surfaces, the solid objects are assumed to be hollow and they are made up of a thin sheet so that can be cut open from one side and unfolded, that particular sheet. So whatever this unfolded sheet that we are laid out on a particular plane paper or on a plane, it is known as development of lateral surfaces of solids. Okay, now why this lateral surface word is coming into the picture? That is because surface of this solid is excluding what? The top portion and bottom portion. That means what? Here, this bottom and top is excluded and only this round portion is considered one. Here also this round is considered one, base is neglected. So therefore it is known as development of lateral surface and not the top and bottom, which is included, which is not included in it. Okay, where is the application of this particular topic? This is applied in the manufacturing of various boiler shells, chimneys, that means the sheet metal parts, trays. Okay, you have already manufactured such a kind of trays in your tinsmithy shop, that is with the help of what? The sheet metal. Now you might have observed this hopper also. Whenever you have visited the flour mill, whatever the container through which the grains goes to the grinding section, that hopper can be manufactured with the help of this kind of development of lateral surfaces is useful in manufacturing of this one. In the similar way, large pipe sections, these body parts, automobile parts, and these body parts of automobiles, aeroplanes and ships, all are manufactured with the help of this. Another thing which I just wanted to share with you is the various, you might have observed the AC ducts, central ACs, you might have visited the city center mall, big bazaar, the various big ducts are there for carrying that cold and hot airs. Okay, so that ducts are also manufactured with the help of this development of lateral surfaces. Now here, very important thing, these are the four points which you should remember. Out of these four, two are very important one. This development is somewhat different than our regular orthographic or isometric projections. No doubt, we are going to include orthographic here in somewhat, up to some extent. This already I have told you, this is nothing but the object laid out on a plane, shape of an object laid out on a plane, showing two-dimensional drawing. Now, this is very important. The true lines are generally visible one in case of developed part, because it is a two-dimensional entity which we are observing totally in proper manner as it is a true one. Therefore all the lengths which are observed in the developed part are what? True length. Now one very important thing is that here nothing is like a hidden portion, everything is laid out on a particular plane. So So whenever the unfolded sheet is there, there will be no edges that can remain hidden. Therefore, we will not get any kind of hidden or dotted line in it. So these two things are very important. Every line, whatever you are getting, is a true length, and you will never get hidden or dotted lines in case of a developed part. Okay, is it fine? Now the next slide. Here, basically, we can draw the development of lateral surfaces by four methods. First one is known as parallel line development method. Second one is known as radial line development method. Other two, that is triangulation method and approximate method, that are not in your syllabus, and therefore we will not going to consider it. Now, the cylinder lateral development and prism lateral development, that can be drawn with the help of what? Parallel line development method. And the cone as well as pyramid lateral development can be drawn with the help of radial line development. Try to remember this one. That is very important one. Okay, so I hope these are the things which are important one for you. Now here, this is a plain cylinder. Whenever we are going to cut this particular hollow cylinder at any one generator, you might be knowing generators, to cylinders there are generators, to cones there are generators, which are imaginary one. But for the prism and pyramid, there are edges. For prism, vertical edges. For pyramid, slant edges. Now for this cylinder, if we cut it at any one generator, imaginary generator, and try to open it up, we will get a rectangle having the length of the rectangle equal to pi d and height equal to the height of the cylinder. Okay, so just for the time being, try to remember this one, because in my next lectures I'll be elaborating this particular topics. Prism, if these are the vertical edges, already have talked about this one. Okay, so these vertical edges, at any vertical edge, if we will cut and try to open it, this particular thing, because prism is having the rectangular faces, top and bottom, maybe of triangle, maybe of square, maybe of pentagon, hexagon, but the sides are of what? It is a rectangular face. These are the rectangular faces. Here you will get a curved portion in case of cylinder. So here, as it is a pentagonal prism, we will get five rectangles. Having one rectangle is equal to the base side of the prism and height equal to the height of the prism. In this way, we will get again a full rectangle, having the length of the rectangle equal to the addition of all the base edges of the prism and height equal to the height of the prism. In case of radial line development method, which is generally used for cone as well as the pyramid. Now, in this cone, we will have what? Base of the cone and height of the cone. So here in this case, the slant height, the actual height is vertical one, passing through the apex. But from this to this, if at all, this length is known as what? Slant height of this particular cone. This is playing a very vital role, which will be taken into consideration. And for cone, we are getting a sector of a circle having length, this length equal to slant height, this angle, which can be finded out by theta, that is nothing but r by l into 360 degree, and which is nothing but a sector of a circle. Just try to remember how to draw it, that we will see in the next lecture. Now for the pyramid again, it is a similar thing. This is a square pyramid having base as a square and the four triangular faces. In case of here, one apex is there, base is there, axis will be like this, and this is a curved part. Imaginary generators are also available here in this case. Here the slant edges are there. How many edges? Square pyramid, four slant edges. Pentagonal pyramid, five slant edges. Triangular pyramid, three slant edges. Okay, so I think you are getting all these things in very proper manner. So here this length is playing again a very vital role, and not the height of the pyramid. This length is a true length, again, that is slant height of the pyramid, for which we are going to draw this one. And here we are not getting a sector of a circle, we are getting the four isosceles triangles, which are placed one beside the other, which is nothing but a developed part of this particular pyramid, excluding this bottom portion, because we are interested in only lateral part of this one. So in this way, it can be drawn. We will again see in the next lecture that how to draw this one, a regular procedure of this. Now frustums. I'm talking about frustums because frustum is nothing but, here I will explain only two solids which are cut by a particular plane. A cone, whenever it is cut by a plane which is perpendicular to axis and parallel to the base of the cone, this part will be removed one. So for this retained part, we are going to draw this development, which is known as frustum of a cone. So it is just like a sector of a circle, but as we are going to draw this one for this one, so this part is not the part of the developed part. So this one as well as these two things. This is already available in our regular cone, but this is required one, as this up to this one only. After cutting this cone, this part is removed from the apex. So therefore we are just drawing it for the retained portion. So here in this case we have to draw the procedure which we are going to draw in case of cone, and then try to convert it as per the requirement of the retained portion. The procedure is similar one, whatever I explain you, but try to convert this as per the retained portion. That again I will tell you with help of a suitable example in next lecture. For the frustum of a square pyramid, or frustum of a pyramid, here it is a square, it may be pentagon, it may be hexagon, it may be triangular, no problem, it can be done. Now here in this case, here also this particular square pyramid is cut with the help of a imaginary cutting plane, perpendicular to axis, perpendicular to axis and parallel to base. So this part is again removed. So here also the procedure is similar one, that how the four isosceles triangles are placed side one beside the other as well as our regular pyramid procedure is considered one square pyramid. But here for this retained portion, we need to make certain changes, and whatever this dark portion you are observing at it now, that is nothing but the actual lateral development of this frustum of a square pyramid. So I think this is a short explanation about what you mean by these various types of solids, what do you mean by development of lateral surfaces, what are its applications, what are the various important points, as well as how the parallel end development method is useful in drawing DLS of, that is development of lateral surface of cylinder and prism, and how radial end development method is useful in drawing the development of lateral surface of cone and pyramid. So for this particular lecture, as far as basics of DLS is considered, this is from my side. We will again meet in the next lecture with some more clarifications, some more details about this one. So till then, this is till then we will wait for next lecture. So thank you very much. These are my references which already have used one from the various books, as well as these are some net material which I have used one. So thank you very much.